So as many of you know, today is the day that most kids are heading back to school after a holiday hiatus. And for many students and parents, the transition may not be an easy one. Here to help with some tips to help everyone get back into their regular routine, education strategist Dwayne Matthews. And full disclosure, Dwayne and I know each other very, very well. And your wife is going back to work as a teacher today.
Yes.
And you have a new little one, newish, who's going to school also. You understand routine. Let's start with sleep. And a new bedtime routine.
So bedtime routine is a huge one. I mean, over the break, I'm sure as you know, my son is going to stretch it out. He's like, I need to read. I need to go to the bathroom. I need milk. And all of a sudden, he's going to bed at 10. So we really have to try and get that back to, a time of the day or time of the night that's really acceptable and gives him enough sleep. Being in school for 6 hours and sitting down in a classroom is really, really difficult. So bedtime is my first number one, work really hard to get that bedtime back in check.
Okay, we'll start that maybe tonight because it's not happening in my house just yet. You say having a good conversation when the kids come home from school today is really important. So what kinds of things should we be discussing or asking the kids?
So one of the things that's really important for somebody to be successful is to really sort of know that adversity is coming no matter what. And a lot of times we try to shelter our kids from that adversity, but we like to have a conversation around what are the things that you liked, but really stress what are the challenges and really start talking about grit and perseverance as a component or an opportunity to really sort of grow. There's nothing more satisfying than having a challenging situation and dominating and winning on that challenging situation. So we really focus on the grit and perseverance, and that's the conversation we start to have. Progress beats perfection all day.
Ooh, progress over perfection. Oh, I'm borrowing that one. Okay, so let's talk about setting goals. It's the new year. A lot of people make resolutions. Should we be doing this kind of thing with our kids too?
Well, I really think about setting goals, but I think having the goals be very specific. So, for example, we may ask our son, like, what do you want to do? He says, I want to read more. Not very specific. If we can get to, I'm going to read more 30 minutes a day, that's very specific. It's something that we can measure, and it's some way to find satisfaction. So one of the things that we've done at home is on the weekend, we have a reading hour where we sit down together, parents and child, and we read. And so now we can do something together, but it's a goal, and it also creates a bond. So I think it's really, really important to set goals.
Okay, so let's now talk about something that you call a habit loop. I'm fascinated by what this sounds like it could be.
So the habit loop is not mine. It's from research done at MIT. And there are three parts to the habit loop. There's a cue, there's a routine, and there's a reward. Now the cue, I'll give you an example. When my son comes home, we may say, okay, you need to go wash your hands. And he may type for 15 minutes. But that cue lets him know that there's a routine that comes. And then the reward is time that we spent together. It might be time where we spent together as a family playing games, or him and I might just be playing video games. But that's the reward, and then we can slot the routine in there. And so that routine can be 10 minutes of extra work, 15 minutes of extra work, and you really can stretch that out. Once you have the cue and the reward in place, the routine does not seem so difficult.
Ooh, I like that a lot. And finally, mindfulness before bed. Mindfulness is a buzzword for adults for sure, but you say it can work with kids, and why at bedtime? Give us an example of what this
looks like. So we come full loop to the beginning from bedtime. And mindfulness, a lot of times when, children have just come out of break, they're like, I can't get to bed, my brain is moving really fast. Mm-hmm. It's a really great time for them to sit and just be with their emotions and to be with themselves and to quiet their mind. And that really, really helps with getting a restful sleep. It really, really helps with having a certain amount of emotional control and mental preparedness. So I think this is really, really key, mindfulness at bedtime. A lot of people were thinking, well, maybe there's more content. I go, we live in a world of content. We should really use the content to teach kids how to think, how to learn, and how to be.
I love all of it. Dwayne, thank you.
Thanks for having me.
Yes, send my best to the family.
I will.